the people of the Chichos. The Coeur d'Alene, as they were called later by the French, first saw the pale face called Suyepos come to their land from where the sun rises. There was one among the tribe who had told of a vision of their coming. In those days, wise were the mighty leaders, and great were their powers to see visions of what was to come. Such were the powers of one called Circling Raven, chief and medicine man of the people who live by the place where the lake pours out, the Chichos. It was said that his medicine was so strong that he could cure ills, cause the winds to blow, could control the minds of people and even the animals of the forest who obeyed him. For many seasons, he was their chief as they became many in number and mighty in strength. He was said to be of the earth, and he knew the earth and its life, and he had powers over these things. Before he died, he brought strong words to his people.
Children, I am old, and soon I will leave you. There is something I must tell you. Moons ago, at early dawn, before the next sunrise, I was praying to the Great Spirit, asking him to send a message I could bring to my people. As I thought of these things that were and things to come, a voice from out of sunrise came to me, and the mountain seems to tremble as lightning flashes across the starland. The voice is like a ton of fire that would speak to all our people.
All the children of the forest must hear the Spirit Chief. Moons upon moons ago, your fathers spoke of me as their great spirit warrior, chief of many camps and battles. Now, they look for me in dawn and sunset. Far across the big water, from a land of many people, who also know the mighty Spirit Chief of all things living, will come a messenger to tell you more about the great Spirit Chief. He is one who wears a black robe to his feet and carries a small iron cross at his side. Before the gray mist floats before you, bringing you to the land of happy hunting, tell these words to your people, that they may be told to their children's children.
Died.
I am pleased that Homotion speaks boldly to you, Twisted Earth. Listen to his wisdom. I would have him for our leader. Give no more ear to such old stories told your fathers by a dreamer crazy with fever. There has been no message from the Great Spirit to me, your medicine man. Would I not be the first to know? That has always been our way.
That is true, Spotted Badger. But look upon my people. What they know about the Great Spirit is only what you tell them, and that is little more than what they already know. Many are the words and signs you make us, but little does your medicine help us.
Twisted Earth, I must warn you, when you make my medicine nothing, you are calling down angry errors from the Great Spirit.
I do not believe you, Spotted Badger, for I do know that men speak falsehood as their eyes are blinded with hate, blinded to the real signs and symbols that tell of a day, not far off, when our camas will be mingled with the strange plants of the Tuyapum. In the country of the Flathead, I have seen them coming, on the prairies, through mountains, riding on their rolling lodges, moving ever nearer to our land of the sunset. The Black Robe is not far from them.
Listen to me, a medicine man! Foolish are these tales of a Black Robe. Northland! Southwind! Eastwind! Westwind! Blow the Black Rope back to his teepee across the Big Water. Blow it back to the land of the many Suyapun.
Yes. Find him, I shall serve his father to dancing sunlight.
I shall see him again soon. You shall never be a father to my child.
Many seasons have passed since the people of the Chitoosh. The Coeur d'Alene, they were called later by the French, first saw the pale face called Suyepos come to their land from where the sun rises. There was one among the tribe who had told of a vision of their coming. In those days, wise were the mighty leaders, and great were their powers to see visions of what was to come. Such were the powers of one called Circling Raven, chief and medicine man of the people who live by the place where the lake pours out, the Stichos. It was said that his medicine was so strong that he could cure ills, cause the winds to blow, could control the minds of people and even the animals of the forest obeyed him. For many seasons, he was their chief as they became many in number and mighty in strength. He was said to be of the earth, and he knew the earth and its life, and he had powers over these things. Before he died, he brought strong words to his people.